Welcome to part 12 of the Builder series. In this video, we'll demonstrate how you can improve the user experience in the classic form layout by using UI policies to make forms more dynamic. This video is a continuation of the Builder series and uses the safety application created earlier. Even if your organization doesn't have a safety department, the concepts demonstrated here apply to a wide variety of use cases. The safety department only cares about the due date for big issues and doesn't need it for small issues. In fact, the due date field shouldn't even appear on the form if the category value is small. So here's the latest requirement from our safety department manager, Luke. Display the due date field on the issue form only when the value in the category field is big. We're going to create some quick no-code logic to make a self-adjusting form to fulfill this requirement. To do that, we've logged into our instance with the admin role, started ServiceNow Studio, and selected our safety app. We'll build a UI policy to make the form more dynamic. UI policies are a great way to change the behavior of information on a form based on the existing form field values without using any code. We can make a field hidden or visible, mandatory or optional, and read-only or editable. We start by clicking Create Application File and then selecting Client Development UI Policy. Here, we select the table that the UI policy applies to. In our case, it's the issue table. Next, we provide a short description to make it easy to identify the purpose of this UI policy. The order field specifies the order that the UI policies run, when there's more than one UI policy on the table and they need to run in a certain order. We only have one, so we'll leave it as is. Now, in the When to Apply section, we build the conditions that'll trigger this UI policy. We want it to run when the category is small. In a moment, we'll specify what actions to take when our conditions are met. Here's the plan. When the category is small, hide the due date field. But often, we also want the system to reverse the effects of the action when the conditions are not met. For example, if our category is small condition evaluates to false, show the due date field. And that's where this reverse if false checkbox comes in handy. If it's selected, when the conditions are true, actions are taken. And when the conditions are false, the actions are automatically reversed or undone. For example, a field that is hidden by a UI policy action becomes visible. That's what we want, so we'll leave it selected. That takes care of when to apply the UI policy, so we submit the form. And now we have two new related lists. This is where we define what we want to do when the condition above is true. We create a new UI policy action and select the due date field. We set the visible field to false, indicating that we don't want the due date displayed when the category is small. Let's also select this checkbox to clear any existing due date field value. Even though the due date field won't be displayed on the form, it may appear on reports and cause confusion when the category is small. So let's fix that during data entry. Just be aware, if your UI policy clears a field value, you cannot get the data back. Finally, we submit our UI policy action. And that's it. Now it's time to test this on an issue record. When we switch the category from big to small, the due date field disappears and any previous due date is cleared. And when we switch it back to big, the field reappears and has no value. Now Luke's employees are making fewer mistakes and he's getting more accurate reports. And we did that all without any scripting. This is so much better than the spreadsheet he used before. One final note on UI policies. If your form needs more than 5 to 10 UI policies, loading it can impact system performance and the user experience. Instead, check into a feature called a view rule. For more information, see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.